In this video, you will find that a gas is flowing down the staircase, as you can see, or a gas-like substance. Now, its motion is quite similar to these marbles that are moving down the staircase, as you can see over here. So, let us study about the movement of particles in the gas in greater detail. Before that, I want you to look at another video. In this video, you will find that a man is blowing air into the balloon and the balloon is bursting. If you observe closely, you will find that the man, while holding the balloon, is blowing air into it and the balloon is gradually expanding, and after a certain point of time it bursts. So why is it that the balloon is bursting when simply what the man is doing is blowing air into it? Let us find out. Over here, a certain gas is kept inside a particular container, and we closely examine the molecular movements inside the gas. Now, as you can see, these gas molecules are randomly moving about in every direction. They don't have any particular direction attached to them. And in doing so, they are colliding with one another as well as with the walls in the container which they are kept. So, as you can see, these gas molecules, when they collide with the walls in this manner, when these gas molecules are colliding with the walls, they are exerting a force on the inner walls of the container, that is, in every direction. If you observe closely, you will find that this force that is exerted by the molecules on the inner walls of the container is perpendicular to the walls of the container. What have we studied about perpendicular forces? A perpendicular force on a surface is also known as thrust. So we can say that these molecules are exerting a thrust on the inner walls. So since these molecules are exerting a thrust, and since these walls have a definite area, we can say that force exerted by the gas molecules per unit area will be the pressure exerted by the gas. So if we consider this, for example, to be unit area, then we can say that these gas molecules that are exerting a force on this area is equal to the pressure exerted by the gas molecules. So we can say that inside any container, a gas that is kept exerts pressure on the inner walls. So now let us consider what was happening when the man blew air into the balloon. When the man is blowing air into the balloon, he is increasing the amount of air or the amount of gas inside the balloon, which means that the number of gas molecules is increasing. These gas molecules collide with the inner walls of the balloon and cause it to expand in all directions. And a point comes when the balloon exceeds its limit and bursts out due to the excessive gas pressure or air pressure inside the balloon. Now consider this animation. Over here, a PET water bottle has been taken, that is a typical plastic bottle, and a hole is made at the bottom on one side. Now as you can see, this water bottle that was initially full is now leaking from this hole. And as it is leaking, the liquid level in the bottle is coming down. Now, why do you think that once this hole is made, the bottle starts to leak? Why is it that liquid flows from the inside of the bottle to the outside? Now, we have to explain this scientifically in terms of pressure. Now, you will notice that when water is leaking from this hole, if you bring your finger and place it on the hole, force will be exerted on the finger. If you make another hole and press your finger to that as well, you will find that a certain amount of force is exerted on that finger by this liquid that is moving down as well, as you can clearly see from this animation. So let us analyze what is going on over here. If we consider the container in which water is kept to be the one that you can see, we can say that if we look down into the molecular arrangement of the molecules in water, we can say that these water molecules are also moving about randomly in every possible direction, and in doing so are colliding or hitting the walls, the inner walls of the container. So even in the previous case, the water molecules were hitting the inner walls of the bottle, Now, in doing so, when these liquid or water molecules collide with the walls of the container, they exert a certain force on these walls. Now, as you can see, these forces that are being exerted on the walls are perpendicular. And we have studied that perpendicular forces are also known as thrust. So we can thus say that these water molecules are exerting an amount of thrust on the inner walls of the container. And if we consider unit area, then we can say that force exerted by liquid molecules or water molecules in this case per unit area is the pressure exerted by the liquid inside the container. In this case, the water inside the bottle. Now let us recall a familiar analogy. When two bodies are kept near one another or in contact with one another at two different temperatures, that is, let's say we have a warm body that has a higher temperature and it is kept near a cool body that has a much lower temperature. There will be a flow or transfer of heat in between these two bodies, and heat will flow from the body which has a higher temperature to the body which has a lower temperature. And heat flow will take place till that time, till the temperature of both the bodies becomes the same. So in a similar manner, fluids, that is liquids or gases, flow from one region to another region only if there is a pressure difference in between the two regions. So just like in the case of heat that flows from hot body to cold body, fluids will flow from high pressure to low pressure. So thus, we can conclude that fluids, liquids or gases always flow from a high pressure region to a low pressure region. So in the case of the water bottle that was leaking, fluid always flowed from the high pressure region to the low pressure region. That is from inside the water bottle to outside it. So what can we say? We can say that since the fluid or water in this case is flowing outside, inside the container, the pressure is high. And outside the container, the pressure is low. And since fluids flow from a region of high pressure to a region of low pressure, in this case, the liquid flowed or water from the inside of the container to the outside of the container. So taking a quick recap, we found that fluids, liquids or gases, always flow in between two points if there is a pressure difference existing in between two points. That is to say that these fluids will always flow from a region of high pressure to a region of low pressure. We also found out with the help of videos and animations that the molecules inside fluids always collide with the walls of the container in which they are kept. So if a gas is kept inside a balloon or water is kept in a bottle, their molecules will be continuously colliding with the inner walls in which they have been kept. So thus, due to this, they exert a certain amount of pressure. And it is due to this pressure difference that a flow of liquids or gases is enabled.